This is Whispering Yelloboi ASMR. So, I am back finally with a brand new mic. It is a blue Yeti X, the Worldcraft version or edition. Let me tell you guys, this is awesome. I really like this mic. I have another blue Yeti, but I cannot use the blue Yeti. Let me turn the main hearing down, gain down. I hope you guys can hear this very well. So, I have another blue Yeti. I'm actually sitting on a chair. The microphone is right here in front of me. My ring light is here. My whole setup is in my living room. There is my kitchen. Those are some of my movies back there. But anyways, I'm just going to show you guys a little bit about what I have back here. So today this is going to be a Whispered Ramble update about my channel and slash a little bit about the a little Best Buy haul. So I got a few movies today and a brand new blue Yeti mic, and this mic is so awesome. I really like it a lot and I can't wait to do more things with this mic. So anywho, again, for you guys who don't know me, my name is Whispering Yelloboi ASMR. I've been on this channel for years now, but I told you guys I was going to get consistent with updating you guys and, you know, recording videos and things like that. Bear with me as I do get better with the editing sounds and things like that. I do look a little tired, I'm sorry, so excuse me for that. And also, my patio door is right here, so you guys might hear, like, you know, some excuse me, I'm kind of conscious. You guys might hear like some traffic and stuff right there, you know, so excuse all of that. But anywho, we're here again. I'm here making a new video for you guys. I'm so excited. So I'm going to go through everything. Man, it's been a tough, crazy ride because I was supposed to upload a video like a week ago. I started recording, but then for some reason my blue Yeti mic stopped. It works, but then it doesn't work. So I don't know what's wrong with it. I replaced the cords. I did everything I was supposed to do, but it still doesn't work. It works, but then it doesn't work. So I got tired of it and just went on and replaced the whole new microphone and got the one that was on sale today at Best Buy since I'm an elite member and I get really good sales at Best Buy. So yeah, Best Buy. I love Best Buy. Most of all of those movies or electronics back there in my kitchen is Best Buy. But anyway, before we get started, I need you guys to do four things for me. Every time you guys see me post a video or anything, please, four things. Four. Number one, I need you to like the video, please. One, give me a thumbs up, like the video. Number two. need you to share my video. And then 4, I need you to subscribe to my channel and make sure you come back and check out the videos or watch them on repeat. I don't care, please. But anywho, I look a little tired. I am tired. But anyways, let's keep moving. So, this is going to... So I'm just going to read a little bit of the front. It says, pickup persons, me, of course, Yelloboi ASMR. Description. Oh my God, I'm so sorry about that. So many noise going on. Stuff that's going on upstairs. I don't like that. Because I can't even hear that with my own ears, but I'm catching it on the mic. Anyways, we're going to keep going. So excuse that, but eventually I'll get better with being able to take that type of stuff out of the video. But right now I can't do it because I don't know how to. Plus, I have to get me a Mac tablet. A Mac. So, you know, I tell you guys, I just recently... Months switching over to iPhone. I used to be a Galaxy guy, so I always had Galaxy Android. Excuse me, because you know, the LA nightlife is still going on outside. It's only 11:19 p.m. here on the West Coast in LA, so thirsty. moving on with the video. Hope the video is not like crazy. I'm sorry, but I'll get better, I promise. Excuse me. Hundreds of HD audio samples from Shadowlands and the World of Warcraft universe. Custom World of Warcraft design provides a powerful on-stream aesthetic. Enhanced Bluetooth voice broadcast vocal effects, including custom presets. Customizable lightning for personalizing your mic. Four versatile pickup patterns, cardioid, omni, bidirectional, and stereo. Plug and play on Mac and PC. Requires Logitech G Hub desktop app. It says it right here on the box. USB mic can change the sound of your voice for fully immersive streaming experience. See, I didn't even know that. Now that I know that, don't be surprised if you guys get a video and if my voice is not my regular voice. It may be some wizard's voice from World of Warcraft. And to any of my subscribers out there who actually know about Warcraft or anything like that, if you guys know about that stuff and you recognize the voice, do comment and let me know, okay? But anyway, Blue Yeti, X-World of Warcraft Edition, professional USB mic can change the sound of your voice for a fully immersive streaming experience. Summon the sound of your favorite Warcraft characters using the all-new voice modulation effect, or celebrate victories with hundreds of Shadowlands and Warcraft HD samples. Switched off the stand right now before this video. I don't know what's wrong with it, but I honestly think it's the USB port, because now I have this new Blue Yeti. I plug it up into this my phone with no problem. All the connections work. I'm only using a single port and it's working fine with my phone. There's no issue. But if I plug this See it, but anyways, basically, whatever, I don't know, I'm trying to zoom, yeah, there it is. So basically, sorry, let me open up the shield, turn the mic over. So basically, what happened is, I think when I first bought the mic, was in a different place, and that's when I had my injury, so I didn't have much use for the mic. I was being very careless of the mic, and I had it hooked up to a little arm stand, you know, arm stand that it comes on, or has that, you know, you can hook it up to a desk as if you are a radio station. Started to feel stand up. I can barely even move. I mean, like, anything. I'm in pain. My head hurts. I can't breathe. My lungs were all messed up. It was just horrible. I was in real pain. I really thought I had the coronavirus, guys. I didn't know what was going on. And by the way, I have not had coronavirus yet, and I pray that I never get it, please. I am fully vaccinated, of course, because my job, and I live in LA. So, anyways, so I get into the urgent care, and I tell them my symptoms of my chest pounding and my throat feeling like it's closing up. The nurse asks me, feel right now, and I tell her I feel really faint and I feel weak, and I don't know if I'm going to sleep or if I'm what or staying awake. So she instantly takes me to a room. She starts monitoring me up and she checks my vitals. My temperature is 99.8. High temperature. As I'm sitting there, I instantly know that's why I started feeling my throat was like, I couldn't feel my throat or my tongue. The doctor finally comes in. I'm kind of skipping some stuff, so I'm not going to make this story time. This is kind of like, oh, whatever, and it's 24 minutes in, so I'm just going to, you know, go over whatever. So she steps back, like, looks like this, and I got scared. I'm like, what do you see? And so she walks around to the other side real quick, and she puts her mom or her little scope in his ear. And then she just says, oh, both of your ears are inflamed. So I tell her that I wear my earphones, not these. They're over there on my couch. So anyways, I have these earphones that I have, my Bluetooth earphones that I wear all the time, even when I'm asleep. I told her maybe that's the reason why. She said, no, the way your ears are inflamed is not the reason why, or it's not, it would not be from earphones being in your ear. Okay, so I get a little scared because I'm like, okay, something is wrong with me now. The doctor knows it. So she says, open your mouth. When I open my mouth, she just says, and I was like, what is it? But I almost bit the thing, because when she said gasp, I instantly was like, what is it? She just said that my throat was severely inflamed and it was closing up. That's why I could not feel my throat, and that's why my throat was cold. She swabbed my throat and she gave me a shot, and she told me that it looks like either strep, or she said she was leaning towards viral pharyngitis because of the symptoms that I was having. Now, I've had sore throats in the past. In my life as a child, we all have. It's a regular thing. This type of sore throat, I have never had. This sore throat made me feel like shit, like I was going to die, because I never felt like this before, ever. Like, I was off of work for about 5 days. First part about it is it affects your throat, but my throat wasn't even affected the worst. It was my head and my stomach that was the worst part about the whole sickness. So I'm just not really sure, but So that's just a little short story time for you guys. You know, that's not my storytelling skills. I gotta write it down because sometimes I will skip the story. Excuse me. Embarrassing. I'm a little sleepy and sorry. I gotta get used to my setup. Let me open up the cage. Okay. Here's the stand that goes with it, the blue Yeti. That's the old blue Yeti stand, though. You guys want me to show you the new one? Hold on. Isn't that so cool? You see it? It came with the little markings on there. And it came with this instruction manual. So I always gotta keep this handy so I can know what is going on with this mic. Thank you. that I can sound, make it sound, you know, because I'm still new at this and I want to do the best I can do. But anyways, which I'm always keeping headphones. I buy so many headphones, you guys, it's ridiculous. Like, if you find me, I have so many headphones. And you know what? Actually, I probably will be giving away some headphones on my channel, probably, because I always get stuff from Best Buy. Like I told you guys, I want to do giveaways and things like this. So here's another extra set of Bluetooth earphones, brand new, that I never even opened, that I have laying around. Which also, by the way, Raycon. I love Raycon. Oh. guys know me, I'm a movie fanatic, and if I was to turn this camera around the other way, let's see if I can do that. It won't let me turn the camera around, but if I was to turn the camera around that way, you guys would see a whole bunch of movies. Oh, I have my TV up there on the wall, and then underneath is like a formation of racks, floating wall mounted racks where the movies are just in there, and it looks like just a whole bunch of movies just in a formation or whatnot. But anyways, if you guys know me, of course, if I went to Best Buy, I didn't just pick up just some electronics. I had to get some new movies that was out also, so I did just that. First movie, give me a drum roll. Da, da, da. Did anybody see Candyman yet? I didn't see Candyman yet. So excited to use it, but then when I found it, it didn't want to work, so now I'm much sound as I can to do the best I can. But anyways, Candyman, a film by Nia DaCosta and producer Jordan Peele. Jordan Peele. You guys better know who Jordan Peele is, right? He is the African American community. Stephen King, I guess. He is the African community's version. Oscar winner Jordan Peele and filmmaker Nia DaCosta unleash a fresh take on the blood-chilling urban legend Candyman. For decades, the house projects of Chicago's Cabrini Green. I knew it was Cabrini Green. I told you guys I was right. I knew that it was Cabrini Green. I remember even when I was younger, Cabrini Green was like in Chicago, I think it was, and I just remember that it used to be like a a supernatural hooked hand killer. Hooked hand killer, y'all. A hooked hand killer. In present day, an artist, Abdul Metin II, begins to explore the macabre history of Candyman, not knowing it would unravel his sanity and unleash a terrifying know me and my creature features, and you also know that I love Emily Blunt, A Quiet Place, and as you can see, this says two. It has both parts, part A Quiet Place Part 1 and A Quiet Place Part 2. And I'm just not even that much better at it anyway, so anywho, I'm gonna go ahead and read the back of this. If they hear you, they haunt you. excuse me, I do apologize about that, but again, I did tell you guys that I am still slightly getting over a cold or whatever it is, whatever it was. So I'm still like kind of clogged up and spitting up mucus and stuff like that. So anyhow, if they hear you, they hunt you. Silence is survival in these two terrifyingly suspenseful thrillers. Follow the Abbott family, Emily Blunt, John Krasinski, Millicent Simmons, Noah Chu, as they face the terror of mysterious creatures that hunt by sound. A Quiet Place. A Quiet Place Part 2. So I'm gonna go back and say that again because I was a little bit off when I was talking about it. So if they hear you, they hunt you. Not haunt, hunt. Do y'all get that? If they hear you, they hunt you. So that means you need to be quiet, because if you make any sound, that means boom, that ass is gone. Silence is survival in these two terrifyingly suspenseful thrillers. Following the Abbott family as they face the terror of mysterious creatures that hunt by sound. A Quiet Place Part 1 and A Quiet Place Part 2. 1, 2, both movies. I was getting ready to watch it, but this is called Escape Room Tournament of Champions. So if you guys haven't saw the first one, you need to, because the first one was very good and it was very fun to watch. It was also crazy because remember when the escape rooms first came out, they were very big, but then they made this movie and it was just like, oh hell no, I don't want to go to no escape rooms no more, because I'm gonna be risking getting stuck in there. Somebody gonna be trying to kill me. What the fuck? No. But anywho, they came out with a movie to make people fear going to escape rooms. This one is absolutely gripping and nerve shredding. I'm pretty sure, because the first one was nerve gripping and shredding too. Like, what the fuck? The situations that they were in was crazy. Like, very crazy. Like, I'm not even gonna spoil it for you guys, but I have it over here somewhere in one of my piles of movies. But if you want to, you can watch it. You guys can come to my house and watch it with me if you want to. Let me know. I'm always down for company. But anyways, so I'm going to go ahead and read the back for you guys. Escape room. That kind of reminded me of, never mind. I'm losing focus. Escape Room. Champions is the sequel to the box office hit psychological thriller that terrified audiences around the world. In this installment, six people unwittingly find themselves locked in another series of escape rooms, slowly uncovering what they have in common to survive and discovering they've all played the game before. So here we are. Another room strangers who's played this game before, obviously. So then something is going to happen to where one of them is going to realize, or I don't know, maybe there's a plot twist in this one, I don't know. But it does look like I see some familiar faces, which I'm not going to point out on here, because I'm just going to let you guys watch it for yourselves. And anybody who else has seen the movies or movies that I have shown, don't ruin for anybody else. And okay, no spoiler alerts, I don't like that. I write movies and I create scripts and things. things like that and acting. So I don't condone it, stuff like that. I take that stuff very seriously. So that's the third movie and the last movie that I got from now from Best Buy. I got that from Best Buy. So those are the three movies that I got from Best Buy today. Okay. So the other thing I wanted to share with you guys is this. So eventually, I will have my tablet back. I'm going to be able to do like true crimes and things like that and play games with you guys and do little reports and stuff like that. So I'm just letting you guys know the only reason why I have not. Well, once I get my tablet fixed, this is my tablet. It's completely broken. It's a Samsung Galaxy, whatever the latest tablet is. And I have the laptop, but as you guys know, I switched over from Galaxy Android over to Apple. So now I'm switching all of my products, my laptops, my everything, systems, all types of things over to Apple products because I did fall in love with Apple things. So tablet that I want to get fixed for you guys. So I'm in the process of getting that fixed for you guys so I can use that tablet to be able to read off of and do some things for you guys from there and be able to edit a little better and do this shit right. Again, excuse me for the breathing because I'm still trying to get my lungs together. That'd be another story too. History in my lungs, so but I'm alright. Trust to believe I'm healthy. Nothing is wrong with me. I'm healthy. I'm fine. I'm good. Other than that, I've been on this video for 58 minutes. This is a Whispered Ramble update. Oh, I want to show you one more thing. So these all broke on the same day. This broke and what I'm about to show you broke on the same day too. So remember how I told you guys that I always have like a numerous headphones sitting around, but I always have a lot of headphones, period. Like, I just have headphones. I love earphones. I love electronics, period. And I'm always looking for the next best electronics out there. No matter how much it costs, if I like it, I want it, I'ma buy it, I'ma get it, I'ma go for it. Just like with this blue Yeti mic. I didn't want to buy a new one, but I mean, I had to because the one that I had isn't working, so I tried to do everything that I knew to fix it, but it wouldn't work, so I just was like, forget it, I'm just tired of playing with it, I'm gonna go out and get a new one, you know. Anyway, this people right here, it's my pride and joy. I love these fucking earphones. And I never would have thought that I liked these earphones or some big ass earphones like this ever in my life, but I love these things. So they're going to do videos with me, or at least a video with me while I'm over there. So I hope you guys will look forward to that, because I'm looking forward to that. Again, I know this wasn't the best video. This was kind of impromptu, but I was planning it on my behalf. Have any questions or any suggestions on what you guys want to hear or what you would like me to do? I just need my channel to grow. I'm becoming more interactive now. I have no more excuses.